Hello everyone, I am Megha Pathak from D.P. Sandhani Ramachaur, your bio teacher. Children, today we are starting animal phylums, and first of all we are going to do phylum Porifera. Okay, so Porifera has the organisms which have pores on their body. Okay, which have pores on their body. So Porifera is a phylum of diploblastic and acoelomate organisms. Children, we have discussed in previous video that diploblastic organisms are the organisms which possess only two germinal layers. Okay, and that is why they are diploblastic. Acoelomate animals means they do not have body cavity. In mesilome, absolutely. That's why they are called acoelomate. And these are non-motile animals attached to some solid support. देखिए नॉन मोटाइल का मीनिंग होता है दे आर नॉट मूवेबल दे डू नॉट मूव सो दे आर नॉन मोटाइल एनिमल्स एंड दे आर अटैच टू सम सॉलिड सर्फेसेस एंड ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैव होल्स और पोर्स ऑन देयर बॉडी ओके एंड इट फॉर्म्स अ कैनाल सिस्टम जो पोर्स उनकी बॉडी में प्रेजेंट होते हैं इससे एक कैनाल सिस्टम फॉर्म होता है ओके जिससे और उसी कैनाल सिस्टम के थ्रू ये अपना फूड लेते हैं ठीक है सो दीज पोर्स leads to a canal system that helps in circulating water throughout the body to bring in food and oxygen. और इन्हीं पोर्स से ये अपना फूड एक कैनाल सिस्टम जो क्रिएट होता है उसी से ये फूड भी लेते हैं और ऑक्सीजन भी इन्हीं पोर्स के थ्रू ली जाती है थ्रू अ कैनाल सिस्टम एंड एनिमल्स आर कवर्ड विद हार्ड आउटसाइड कवरिंग और इट इज कॉल्ड skeleton तो जब skeleton it is present outside the body so it is called exoskeleton okay So, body design involves minimal differentiation. इनकी जो body होती है they possess simple body design. Generally, इनमें cellular level body organization होता है okay? जो similar cells होती है they do not form tissues. And mostly found in sea. These are marine organisms. इनमें ज़्यादातर जो होते हैं वो marine होते हैं marine जो कि sea में रहते हैं And examples are Euplectella, Cycan and Spongella. These are the examples of the organisms. Porifera.
Children, these are the examples of phylum Porifera. As you can see on the screen, Euplectella, Cycan, and Spongella. Now, next phylum is Coelenterata, or we also call it Cnidaria. Coelenterata is a phylum of diploblastic animals having tissue level organization. देखिए जो फाइलम सीलेंटरेटा है और निडेरिया इसमें जो ऑर्गेनिजम्स होते हैं दे आर डिप्लोब्लास्टिक एंड दे शो टिश्यू लेवल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इनमें टिश्यू लेवल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन होता है ओके एंड दीज एनिमल्स लिव इन वाटर दे शो मोर बॉडी डिज़ाइन डिफ्रेंशिएशन देखिए फाइलम पॉरीफेरा में जो ऑर्गेनिजम्स होते हैं उनमें सेल्युलर लेवल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन होता है मीन्स जो सेल्स हैं वो ही स्पेशल फंक्शन परफॉर्म करती हैं वाइल निडेरियंस दे आर डेवलप्ड मीन्स मोर डेवलप्ड देन पॉरीफेरेंस ओके बिकॉज दे शो मोर बॉडी डिज़ाइन डिफ्रेंशिएशन देयर इज अ कैविटी इन द बॉडी ये जो ऑर्गेनिजम्स होते हैं इनमें बॉडी कैविटी प्रेजेंट होती है एंड द बॉडी इज मेड ऑफ टू लेयर्स ऑफ सेल्स वन makes up cells on the outside of the body and the other makes the inner lining of the body. They have very simple tissue organization. ये जो organisms हैं ये tissue level organization show करते हैं. And all the animals, all the organisms of this phylum are aquatic. And mostly they are marine. But except Hydra, because Hydra, it lives in fresh water. And these organisms are radially symmetrical because their body can be divided into two halves by any plane passing through the center. देखिए ये जो organisms हैं ये radial symmetry show करते हैं. And what is radial symmetry? We have studied earlier. जिसमें body में से कोई भी central axis में से जो passing line होती है imaginary line होती है it divides the body into two equal halves. So these animals they show radial symmetry. These organisms have only one opening in the body, which is used for both for feeding and the elimination of waste material. And these organisms, they have tentacles and they have stinging cells also.
And stinging cells are also called needleblast.
And these organisms, they absorb oxygen through their body surface. ये अपनी body surface से oxygen absorb करते हैं.
Some of these species lives in colonies. देखिए कुछ organisms colony में भी रहते हैं. For example, corals. While others have a solitary lifespan, like hydra.
Hydra, Aurelia, or we call it jellyfish. And sea anemone, these are the examples of the organisms which are categorized, which are grouped in phylum Cnidaria. Or we call it Coelenterata also. Now children, next phylum about which we are going to study is phylum Platyhelminthes.
Platy means flat or helminthes means worms. So Platyhelminthes is a phylum of flatworms. ये जो organisms होते हैं ये flatworms होते हैं. And where the body is dorso-ventrally flattened.
And the body of animals in this group is far more complexly designed than in the two other groups.
देखिए अभी जो हमने दो phylums के बारे में पढ़ा उन phylums से इस phylum के जो organisms से they are more developed.
Children, just now we have studied that poriferans, they do not have any symmetry in their body. Poriferans जो है वो कोई भी उनकी बॉडी में कोई भी सिमेट्री नहीं होती है. While Cnidarians और Coelenterates, they have radial symmetry. Means कोई भी सेंटर में से जो पासिंग लाइन होती है it divides their body into two equal halves. And you know, these organisms means the organisms which belongs to phylum Platyhelminthes, they are bilaterally symmetrical. Meaning that the left and right halves of the body have same design. And these organisms are triploblastic. Means there are three layers of cells from which differentiated tissues can be made. Triploblastic means animals having three germinal layers. Ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm. And this allows outside and inside body linings as well as some organs to be made. But there is no true internal cavity or coelom. And coelom in which well-developed organs can be accommodated.
These organisms possess soft, elongated and usually dorso-ventrally flattened leaf-like or tape-like body. And they are mostly parasite. Parasite means they live on host organisms and mostly they are endoparasites. Means ये जो host organism है उसकी body के अंदर रहते हैं like tapeworm. But some are free living. Free living जैसे Planaria. And they show organ level of organization. देखिए organ level organization और organ system level of organization both are different. इनमें कुछ organs present होते हैं. And in these organisms body cavity is totally absent. Body cavity which is called coelom. Planaria, liver fluke and tapeworm are the examples of the organisms which are grouped in phylum Platyhelminthes. देखिए Planaria ये एक free living Platyhelminth है. And Taenia solium जिसे हम pork tapeworm भी बोलते हैं. जो लोग uncooked pork खाते हैं, pig खाते हैं, उनकी body में ये pork tapeworm हो जाते हैं. And most of the members of phylum Platyhelminthes are endoparasites. Means ये organisms की host organisms की body के अंदर रहते हैं. और ये हमेशा host को नुकसान पहुंचाते हैं.